a massive jolt happened, and I was awakened, and I looked up to see the gentleman that was sitting next to me on the roof of the plane. I'm looking at him fully outstretched with his back on the roof of the plane. And then he came crashing down to the floor. It was insane. I was like, I thought I was dreaming. So anyone that was not in a seatbelt just flew randomly all across the plane. The plane basically stopped. Like, it almost, the best way to describe it is it's dropped out of the air instantly. And then it started to tail down, like nose down. And then it just picked up. It just kicked into gear and just took off again. And I was like, I was sure it was over. I was like, this is heading down. And then once it stabilized, there was no further turbulence, no nothing.
We dropped and it happened in a split second. And then suddenly all the devices and bags were up near the roof. And then next moment, everything was scattered on the ground. It was people scared, screaming, crying, and lots of injuries.
So we had about 45 minutes to fly to get to Auckland. So we hit the ground, we landed, everyone applauded. And then they said, right, everyone sit tight. We're going to get the injured off the plane first. I saw cut heads, a few neck braces being applied, people being patched up with cuts and bruises. The gentleman beside me suffered some rib injuries. There was clearly some panicking, just like people hyperventilating and panicking. But again, you're only confined to a small part of the plane, so I can't speak for the rest of the plane. But and I know there was a serious injury at the back because everyone was focused on there. One of the crew was non-functional.
I was quite calm in the intense situation, and there were lots of people who weren't. Mm. So I dealt with it fine, and I was able to provide some first aid to those around me.